If I were to ask everyone sitting here, what is the most important thing to remember all the time? People would probably say my birthday, or maybe the marriage day. What do you say? What is the most important thing to remember? The most important thing to remember is who you are. So who are you? Soon, you're slowly gonna understand why that's something that you always need to remember. Who are you?
אם אני עכשיו קורא לכבוד הרב, אני מתכוון למהיר שלו.
If the Rav would now address me, is he referring to my jacket?
או לחוצה שלו?
Is he referring to my shirt?
לא, נכון שלו.
Of course he's not referring to
me. גם אני לא מתכוון לגוף שלו.
He doesn't even refer or mean my body.
אלא מה אני מתכוון? לנשמה שלו.
When he turns to me, what does he mean? He's referring to my soul. Because the body too is merely a clothing for the soul, for the
neshama.
So when I say you, what do I mean? I mean your soul. I mean your neshama. When I look at the women's section and I say you, what do I mean? I mean your soul, your
neshama.
And what is the soul of every single one of us? Our soul is a part of Hashem, of the creator of the world. The verse in the Mishnah says that Hashem breathed into man the breath of life. The Holy Zohar says that Hashem breathed into man a part of Hashem himself. Each and every single one of us, our neshama, our soul, is part of Hashem. The most evil person in this world that committed the greatest sins, and he now is now falling asleep. When he wakes up in the morning, what does he say? My God, my Lord, the soul that you gave me is pure.
Anshama, ifshar, anshama, ata ze anshama.
You are your soul.
Ata ze tov.
You are good.
Ata rotze rak la'asot tov.
You only want to do good.
Ara ze lo.
The bad, the evil, that's not you.
Ara ze yetzer hara.
The bad parts, that's the evil side, the yetzer hara.
כשאדם יודע באמת לעשות את ההפרדה הזאת, הוא ממש בצורה ממש חותכת.
When you clearly know how to make that separation,
הוא ינצח את היתרה שלו לגמרי תמיד.
You will be able to defeat the gates of hell, the dark side always.
כל מה שאדם בעצמו, בייאוש,
the only reason a person falls into sadness, disparity, he fails, he doesn't manage to succeed, is because the dark side tells him that the bad part, the evil part, that's part of him.
אדם אפילו יעשה את העבירה הכי גדולה בעולם.
Even if a person commits the gravest sin in the world,
צריך להגיד, אני לא רוצה את זה.
He must say, I don't want this.
זה לא אני.
It's not me.
לא התגבר, היה שלה, התגבר עליי.
The dark side overcame me.
בגלל ששכחתי מהתחלה שזה לא אני.
Because I forgot that from the beginning the dark side is not me. Slowly, slowly we're going to understand this concept. I'd like to read you several sections of what Rabbi Natan of Breslev writes. In his book, Likutei Halachos, Rabbi Natan writes,
איך יכול להיות שרשע חוזר בתשובה? איך יכול להיות שרשע, איך יכול להיות רשע לחזור בתשובה? איך?
He asks a question, how can an evil person do תשובה? How can he repent?
הרי עבירה גורמת עבירה.
We know this of rule. A sin causes another sin to happen, and another sin.
באמת, איך יכול פתאום לחזור בתשובה?
So in that case, how can he do tshuva? How can he repent? Right, Rabbi Natan.
כל מה שעובר עבירה יותר, הוא נופל בידי הסתרה עוד יותר.
Let's explain it a bit more. Rabbi Natan writes, every single time that you sin, you fall even deeper into the clenches of the dark side.
אז מאין יבוא, בסוף יתגבר נגד הסתרה.
So if he falls deeper every time he sins, how is he eventually able to overcome the dark side?
תבינו, עושה עבירה, אז נכנס קצת הסתרה. עוד עבירה, עוד יותר, כל הזמן, עוד יותר, מתגבר עליו, ממש, אז כאילו הוא נכנס עוד בחושך ובחושך ובחושך ובחושך.
Understand, every single time a person commits a sin, he falls deeper and deeper into the dark side. It's like falling deeper and deeper into a dark pit. So how can you overcome it? How can you crawl out?
אז הוא אומר, באמת, בכל אחד יש נשמה יקרה שיש לה כוח גדול לעמוד כנגד היצרה.
Says Rabbi Natan, because really and truly, every single one of us has a dear and valued neshama soul that can overcome the dark side and all of its forces.
אין מציאות שבן אדם יתנו לו יצרה יותר מאשר הוא יכול לעמוד כנגדו.
There is no reality that a person would get a dark side that is stronger for him to be able to overcome.
לכן, פתאום, הנשמה פתאום באיזשהו שלב, פתאום מקבלת כזה, דווקא שכבר רוצים ממש לברוע אותה לגמרי, פתאום, ממעמד האדם, אבל פתאום מקבל ממש, פתאום הוא ממש מקבל כזה מקובל, מה, איפה הוא ממש מקבל כזה התעוררות, וזהו. והרגע שאתה רוצה, הוא מנסה את כל הרשות.
Therefore, the soul, when it falls deeper and deeper into the clenches of the dark side, it eventually awakens and gets such a strong power that it's able to overcome the dark side and all of its forces.
ועל כן צריכים לדעת,
and that's why you need to know,
ולהאמין,
and believe,
שבוודאי, ובוודאי,
that certainly and certainly,
כל אחד ואחד,
each and every single one of us, even the smallest of the small, has a great power to stand and to face and defeat his own dark side. And the main reason that a person falls to sin, to transgression, is because he's unaware of his power. רבי נחמן מברסלב writes in his book, ליקוטי מוהר"ן,
שיר.
He writes a song.
בשיר כותב.
In the song he writes,
חזק ונתחזק.
Let us grow stronger and stronger.
ואל תהיה כפיל.
And do not be like an elephant.
פיל הגדול.
A big elephant.
שהולך, קושרים לו חוט לרב שלו.
They tie to him a very, very small thin string.
They קושרים את זה לזנב של האחמר.
They tie that string from the elephant's nose to the tail of the mouse.
הולך על האחמר.
And the elephant follows the mouse.
תציירו לעצמכם
כרוכה. Imagine that, that's hilarious. It's a massive elephant, massive. It's walking and being led by this tiny little mouse. And all of this, why? It's because the elephant is unaware of his power. The elephant doesn't realize that it can crush this mouse in an instant. So too is a man who follows his dark side. The dark side is just like a tiny little mouse. The Gemara in Tractate Sukkah says,
כולם רואים את היצרה, או שוחט את היצרה, הם אומרים, השעים רואים שהיצרה שלהם היה כמו חוט קטן.
The Gemara in Tractate Sukkah, page 52, says that in the future, in the times to come, when Hashem shall slay the dark side, those evil people who didn't manage to defeat it will see that their dark side was nothing more than a thin, thin string. And they start crying. How could we not defeat such a tiny little thin minute dark side? Rabbi Nachman of Breslov also writes
that
good thoughts, that is the Yetzer HaTov, the good side. And bad thoughts, those are the dark side. So what is the dark side? It's merely thoughts. That's why every single one of you has the mind and the wisdom to overcome his dark side. Rabbi Nachman also writes that the Yetzer Hara, the dark side, is nothing more than an imagination, an imaginary power. You imagine that you can't overcome it. You imagine that you have to now touch this chocolate. If you won't touch it, you won't be able to live. All the lusts are merely imagination. He imagined that he can't, he must, he has to have it. And that's why Rabbi Nachman writes at the end of that poem. But my soul is smart and clever and strong. So what did we learn? Why does a person fall and succumb to his dark side? Because he doesn't know his own power. Just like the elephant doesn't realize his own
power.
In the Hasidus and the Kabbalah, there are concepts which are called Moichin de Gadus, a large mind, and Moichin de Katus, a small mind.
Moichin de Gadus, the Namu, Yudama Koshalo, Bu, Samea,
Moichel Begadus is when a person realizes his own power, he's happy, he's self-confident. Moichel Begadus is small-minded means that a person is unaware of his own power. That's why he feels sad and weak, because Moichel Begadus, a small mind, is not realizing your own power. Rabbi Natan, these are the words that he uses, that his mind becomes smaller, and his power diminishes, and is unaware of his own strength and forces. And he imagines that he's unable to overcome this lust and desire. Rabbi Natan writes that every single one of us has the mind and the knowledge and the power.
As it
says in Qoheleth, that the wisdom is stronger for a person than 10 governors who govern a city.
היינו שעיקר הכוח להיות עד כנמר כנגד כל התאבות והפיתויים ורק על ידי חוכמה אמיתית שבחינת מוחין וגלגלות.
Meaning that the main power that a person has to be as fierce as a tiger to overcome the dark side is realizing his own power, which is called Moichel Begadus, a large mind.
עכשיו רבי נתן עושה לנו סיכום.
And now Rabbi Natan comes and concludes the whole matter.
הכלל, שהאדם צריך להאמין מאוד בכוחו.
The rule is that a person must believe very much in his own power. And he should know with true faith and belief
שבוודאי יש בכוח שכלו ומוחו לעמוד כנגד כל התאוות ונגד כל הישראלים שבעולם.
That certainly it is in the power of his mind and his wisdom to overcome and to face all the negative lusts and desires and his dark side. Now everyone heard what I just said. Even though you all heard what I just said, inside the dark side is persuading you and telling you it's true, but it's not talking about you. It's not relevant for you. It's talking about the tzaddikim, the righteous people, but you have a small soul. You're weak, you're powerless, you're unable to overcome me.
ברוב שכל החיים, העזרה משכנע אותך שאתה לא יכול, שאין לך כוח. כל החיים אתה לא שווה כלום, ואתה רע. כל החיים הוא משדר לך שאתה רע, שאתה רשע, שאין לך תקנה, שאין לך... כל החיים הוא משדר לך במוח.
Because all of our lives, the dark side is persuading us and telling us that we can't, that we're not worth it, that we're evil, that we're powerless. Our whole lives, that is what the dark side has been doing, persuading us that we can't. He keeps persuading you that you can't. Rabbi Nachman of Breslov writes that the dark side is not looking for you to sin. That's not what interests him. He's looking for you to be sad and and depressed and feel powerless after you sin. What the Yetzer Hara, the dark side, gains is not the sin itself. Because when we talk about sin, the rule is that you even just think of repentance, all your sins are immediately forgiven. You go to a bris, all your sins are repented and atoned
for.
You come to a Shia, you get good wills and desires, all your sins are repented and atoned for. Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur, Shabbos. People don't know this. A person who preserves the Shabbos properly, his sins are atoned for even more than Yom Kippur can atone for. So even a simple Jew who only preserves and guards the Shabbos, every single Shabbos, all of his sins are atoned for. So what does the Yetzer Hara gain from causing you to sin? Nothing. His gain is that he persuades you that you're bad, that you're evil, that you can't amend yourself. He brings you into sadness, to disparity. That's the gain of the dark
side.
Because for years over years we have believed the dark side when he says this. Even though he hears the things I'm saying now in this shir, he's so persuaded by his dark side that he doesn't believe that what I am saying relates to him. He believes his dark side, that he can't, that his weakness.
Hours.
People come to me. Poor people with such difficult mental and emotional problems. And I know exactly why they're in such a hard situation. I tell them, please repeat after me. I am a pure soul. I am a holy soul. I am good. I only want to do good. I only want to be as Hashem wants me to be. Because the evil side, the dark side, is not me. The dark side, the evil things are the dark side, the Yetzer Hara, not me. Repeat after me. And I say to him, it's worth your while to believe me, don't believe your dark side. But what can I do? He believes his dark side and he remains crazy with all of his problems. All of the crazy people, and you are all crazy people. Funny, huh? Anyone is a bit crazy. A person who's angry is crazy. A person who's envy and jealous is crazy. A person who worries is crazy. Why? Have you ever seen a little boy that worries? You start sitting there thinking, oh, what's going to happen with my food today? Am I going to eat? Am I not going to eat?